దేశ జనాభాకు అనుగుణంగా లోక్సభ సీట్లను 1000 స్థానాలకు పెంచాల్సిన అవసరం ఉందన్నారు భారత మాజీ రాష్ట్రపతి ప్రణబ్ ముఖర్జీ. ప్రస్తుతం ఎన్నికైన ఎంపీలకు ఓటర్లకు మధ్య నిష్పత్తిలో భారీగా అసమానతలు ఉన్నాయన్నారు. 1977లో 55 కోట్ల జనాభా కోసం లోక్సభ సభ్యులను 543కు పెంచుకున్నామన్నారు ప్రణబ్. ప్రస్తుతం దేశ జనాభా 100 కోట్లు దాటినందున అందుకు అనుగుణంగా లోక్సభ సీట్లను రెట్టింపు చేయాల్సిందేనన్నారు.
The last enhancements of the seats in Lok Sabha took place in 1977, almost half a century ago, on the basis of 1971 census, according to which the entire population of the country at that point of time was 550 million, not 1.3 billion today. Therefore, there has been an embargo on the increasing the number of seats in Parliament and State Assembly till the year 2026. This has resulted in the fact that the number of voters for Lok Sabha constituency as per 2011 census has risen to more than 16 lakh. In the last general elections of 2019, approximately 90 crore voters were enrolled and were eligible for voting 543 members of the Lok Sabha. Nearly two-thirds of them exercise their voting rights. With an average 16 to 18 lakh people having one representative in Parliament, how can we expect the representative to be in touch with the electorate? There is a strong case for removing this fringe on the number of seats in the delimitation exercise. Whenever there is a question of removing this fringe of the number of seats, which should ideally increase to about 1,000 Lok Sabha MPs, with correspondingly rise in the number of Rajya Sabha MPs, more than often the arguments are given the logistic problems. I do consider it is no major problem. Even with the existing infrastructure available, Central Hall could easily be converted into Lok Sabha. Lok Sabha can easily be converted into Rajya Sabha, and Lok Sabha can be converted into the lobby, or Central Hall's role can be assigned to it.